We just have one more thing to do on our setting spa. So setting spa, there are three things to do. One is to change our time zone. Two is to tell it that we want to have static files. And then the last thing we're going to do there is to tell it where our website will be hosted. Are you with me? Where would you post this our website? Are you okay? We are going to tell you where we want to post this website, which is at 31. So we are going to my 31 on our... What's happening here? No problem. Once you get this, you'll notice that there is one piece of entry for us. If you want one, what do you want? Allowed post basically saying from where and where would we be putting this website? When you created the website, you see that, let's go to Sublime, Sublime, line 28 in Sublime. Are you on line 28 of Sublime?
Yeah.
Have you seen Allah post there?
Yeah.
On line 28 of Sublime?
Yeah.
Have you all seen it?
Yeah.
You notice that initially the bracket was empty. Are you okay?
Yeah.
So it says, okay, I've created a website, but where are you going to post this website? We have to tell it where we are going to host this website. Are you confused?
No.
So, where we are going to host this website, the website you are designing today, the one we are doing, this one that we are doing today, we are going to host it in two places. Are you with me?
Yeah.
We're going to host it in two places. The first place you are going to host it is on your own computer. The second place we are going to host it is online, on a website that is called pythonanywhere.com. So if, let's say, I was the one who came to you and said, build me a nice website, and I want my website to be called abotopuku.com, champion number one. And that is where I want to host my website. That is what you're going to write at AllowHost. AllowHost will be the domain name, that's where people will see the website. If by God's grace, tomorrow, miracle happens, Facebook say that they want you to design their new website in Django, and they say our website address is www.facebook.com, what would you put under AllowHost? You can put your computer name and Facebook.com. The only reason why we put our computer name in there is because we are developing on our computer. So that it allows us to work on it whilst on our computer. Or else we'll not be able to view it like a website. So the AllowHost is always empty, waiting for you to tell it where the website will be hosted. Anybody confused?
Yes.
You are confused? You want me to move out? Are you okay? So AllowHost, a host is Baba Mifie, Namajo, me a host. We're all for. You understand? I'm hosting you. So the host is usually the server. The server hosts the website. So when you are doing your settings, it asks you, where is this website going to sit? Who is going to host it? Which machine? And that's why the first time you go into Sublime settings, the AllowHost area, which is line 28, is empty. For today, we say we are going to host this our website that we are creating in two places. The first place we're going to host it is on our own machine. Now, the truth is that almost all laptops and desktops that run some form of server, all of them have the same server address. It's called 127.0. Post it on 127. So you call it your local server. You call it your local server. Are you okay? So we are going to post it on your local server, which is your PC. That's the 127 blah blah blah. And then we are going to post it for free on somebody's server. And that somebody's server is Python for Cyber Media Chains and Empire. It's called pythonanywhere.com. Is it confusing? So those two things are what you are copying and putting inside line 26, line 28. Are we all there now?
Yeah.
So is your line 28 saying something like AllowHost space equals space? Then it has a bracket, then two items inside, then a comma, then two items inside, then close by another bracket. For the price of a beautiful sticker, what does that line look like when today we'll be doing some things today? AllowHost space equals bracket. And lives. Are you seeing it? It's a list. So basically, it's a list of the places we want to host our website. It's a list. Remember we did with list. So you see that we are still working in Python. So we are dealing with a list of places we can host our website. Are we all done with line 28? So there are a couple of lines we are changing. One of the only three lines we make changes to. One was the time zone, which we changed from UTC to Africa, Accra. Then the other one we added at line 121, which was to say we're going to have static files. And then the last one we are changing is on line 28, which is where we will host our website. Everybody fine?
Yes.
Yeah. Now, we've made these changes, isn't it? Are we okay?
Yes.
Go to file and save. Make file save. So we want to save all our changes. Or you can do Control S. Control S or file save. We have saved these settings. Are we fine? Okay, let's go to our tutorial file. Are we okay? So now anytime we are designing a website, websites are made up of two main parts. Are you with me? A website is made up of two main parts. So if you go to facebook.com or any website, in simple terms, it's made up of two parts, right? One part is just the way we save our pictures and things like that, videos. It's basically like that's what we save everything. The other part is what we call the database. The database does not save anything like pictures or things. Database is like Excel. See the way Excel is? So, for example, a database. Oh, come on, let me find my pen. Okay, let's see if you can remember Excel. So imagine that you're in Excel. Imagine, So imagine you're in Excel, this is the Excel sheet. Are you okay? And usually what we do is, you write first line A, 1, matre, name, yes sir. Then B, 1, matre, age. C, 1, matre, sex. D, 1. Then D will be something like address. Are you okay? These are just the headings, isn't it? So when you take the first person and you start, what is your name?